Please like, comment, and subscribe.
Hey!
Hey, you guys.
Welcome back.
Welcome back.
Hey, this is Dre.
This is Alsina.
And this is another episode of Sipping and Talking Shit.
Yes. So, you guys, welcome back. And if you are new to our channel, please like, comment, and subscribe. So, first we have up is Dr. Dre's wife, Mrs. Nicole Young. Yes, so she is divorcing her husband. Yes, you guys, after 24 years of marriage, citing irreconcilable differences.
After 30 years? Bitch.
Almost. I mean, we don't necessarily know what's going on, but she's just, I mean, they're at a point in their lives where they're not seeing eye to eye.
24 years?
I mean, it's probably been before the 24 years. They probably, and I'm not going to say because I don't know what's going on in their relationship, but I mean, it's probably.
But it's like, you leaving Dr. Dre the billionaire, bitch. Who you finna go to? What you finna do?
I mean,
what, you got an old fling from the past, Mr. Jeffrey?
We don't necessarily know what's going on with them. I mean, maybe she's just probably tired of living their life. Maybe she won't out. Y'all thoughts?
He said that shit like they about to yell them back to the screen.
I'm just saying, like, what are y'all thoughts about it? Like, I mean, would y'all still stay within the marriage if y'all know that it's going sour?
But 24 years.
It can make people get divorced after 40, 50 years of marriage.
24 years. Nigga, she was down with Dre during the NWA almost time era.
Yes, she was. And now she is.
I bet you was there through all the diamond platinum albums, all the beats. All that motherfucking shit Dre went through, you want to skate now?
That don't mean nothing. That just means that she is probably tired of his crap and she is ready to go ahead and go. Y'all don't know what these women go through behind closed doors.
Oh, he probably tired of her shit.
Well, he didn't file for divorce. She did.
Oh, well. No. That because he ain't want him to, he ain't filed because he ain't want her to take none of his motherfucking money.
Look.
So he dealt with the motherfucking shit to see the size she wanted to go take the money.
This woman's about to cash in and. This is allegedly, y'all, allegedly. It's also stated that there may not have been a prenup for their marriage. So.
Ding dong, the witch is dead.
So. I think that she should get some money. I mean, if she's been there with him throughout all everything.
You ain't gonna lie, bitch been down with you for 24 years, man.
She deserves something. Come on now.
Yeah, no doubt. I even give you something. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't gonna lie. It ain't like something you just, one of these chicks you just caught up with. You know what I'm saying?
No, like, this has been your wife for 24 years, you guys. So,
motherfucking smelled your shit for 24 years, fam.
You know, smell somebody else's shit.
I wouldn't just stay where I'm at, keep the shit I'm around. I don't want no new shit.
Well, you know what, you guys? I mean, it's sad, but I mean, we just wish them both the best, and you know, hey, I mean, they had a good run within their marriage, and now it's just time for them to embark on a new journey without one another. So, you know,
yeah, that is it's kind of unfortunate. That sucks, though. You know, you kind of want to see relationships land.
Yeah,
you don't want to see, especially black relationships. You don't want to hear.
You don't see that nowadays. You don't see that,
especially not after no 24 goddamn years. It's like, bitch, you ain't going nowhere. Where you gonna go?
She gonna go somewhere.
Nah, I ain't letting you go nowhere.
You can't.
She know all the secrets. Everything this nigga, all these little old secrets. That bitch been, man, you ain't going nowhere. I say, hey, all right, you want a new man? Get the nigga and go to the other side of the house. This big motherfucker, you ain't going nowhere.
Look, she finna go somewhere and take his money elsewhere.
Man, shit. I'll make her fight. I got all the motherfucking money. I'm going to give you the sorriest motherfucking lawyer you can find. I'm going to fight. I'm going
to
say.
I mean, he does have the money to fight her in court. But I mean, but then you got to look at it. If she doesn't have the money to pay for her lawyers, then you're going to have to pay for that. How is she going to pay for it? You're the one with all the money.
Yeah, I pay for them. I pay for my right. I get her a local lawyer. I get a team of the local lawyers around the corner. They ain't giving them one of them high-powered lawyers.
Look, I'm not even about to marry you with a prenup. I'm sorry. I'm not coming into that relationship with a prenup. I'm sorry.
Well, American Airlines, they stopped. I'll tell you what, look.
What?
I tell you what.
Look, y'all, I'm gonna come
for
you.
She had to leave after 24 years, damn it, she had to leave. I think she put in enough motherfucking work. I think any person in the world could motherfucking me say that, you know, 24 years is enough motherfucking work. All right, if you, damn, you got to feel like you got to leave after 24 years.
I mean, maybe she was wanting to leave before then. I mean, come on.
Yeah, well, she let it get to 24.
I mean, well, maybe, like most of us women, we try to think that maybe it's going to work on out, and it doesn't. So, I mean, look, we wish them the best of luck. It ain't our marriage, and we don't know nothing about it, so.
And you know what? Because of their budget, we got to change the subject.
Okay, y'all. Okay, we're going to go ahead. So, anyways, in the next up-and-coming docket, we got American Airlines. So, you guys, American Airlines, and this is allegedly. Now, American Airlines, they are going to stop social distancing, and they're also going to start now booking flights to capacity. You know what? Y'all about to have coronavirus all up and through y'all airlines. Like, why would you do that? Y'all see people are dying, like, come
getting on.
Getting
on a flight is just, you're going to be stepping straight into coronavirus.
I'm not getting on a flight.
It's going to be called Coronaville in them cabins.
Who, okay, my thing is this. Who is the president? Or who is the vice president? Or whoever, like, why? I mean, I understand, look.
Man, that man trying to make some bread, and he know people is ignorant as hell, so he opened the floodgates.
No, but okay, so is it all about money or it's all about saving lives like this? That's crazy.
Definitely all about money.
Okay, but look, y'all got enough money in y'all pockets. You don't have to book flights to full capacity. You don't have to. Come on. Now, look, that's y'all. If y'all want to go ahead and go out there and get on Sickville Airlines, go right ahead.
Sickville, that was a good one, baby. Okay.
But I mean, I just feel like I'm not getting on no flights. No time soon. I've never been on a flight, but I'm not getting on one. It's not that much.
On a jet plane. I don't know when I'll be back again.
Who's that song?
It's an old white song.
Okay. But I'm not getting on any flights. What about you?
I ain't getting on no motherfucking flights.
Well, not if you have like that full gear.
I'm not getting on. Damn, if I had a hazmat suit, I'm not getting on there because that corona will leak through a hazmat suit. It'll do that. Corona is a killer. This motherfucker been taking niggas out like goddamn Bruce Lee. This motherfucker. Corona. Fire! Niggas been dying and shit. This shit is crazy. I'm not feeling this.
Yeah, we're not paying no mind today.
I'm not feeling it.
Look, this is only just the first wave. They said that it's more to come. So yeah. Y'all go on out there and get on American Airlines or whatever else airlines y'all want to go get and get on. I'm trying to tell y'all, this is just the first wave. We are going to be stuck in our houses for some time to come. So y'all just try to stay safe. I mean, I am just stating, don't go on out there. It's not worth to sit on the beach.
And don't go get on no motherfucking, don't book no flight, fam. Don't be lazy. If the motherfucking ride is under 14 hours, goddamn it, y'all just got to switch up and take your rental car and drive, fam. The way you can control what you're around. Don't go hop on no damn flight when you got too many motherfucking opportunities to be motherfucking subjected or object, whatever that word is, where the corona be near you. You don't want the corona around you. Too many chances. You know what the fuck I'm trying to say? Shit.
I'm not gonna play with you. But yeah, you guys, just be safe. Be safe right now. I mean, we don't know how long everyone is trying to clock a virus. It is a virus. You cannot clock it. It's gonna be here for whenever it's gonna be here. So if y'all don't want it here, then create, which we already know y'all have one. Create an antivirus. So then that way that no one is gonna, you know, continue to die. But y'all is just trying to control this population.
Ooh.
Sorry.
Don't get it with that one, baby.
I see it.
Ooh,
y'all know
scorching.
It is the truth.
Oh, she hot, y'all.
Y'all know it is the truth. Come on.
All right, well.
Anyways, y'all be safe on out there. In the next news, and this is going to be allegedly. Now, y'all already know. I'm about to come in here and bring it to y'all. we got Mr. August Alsina. We have never had him on the show or talked about him.
I love this part every time you speak. Yeah, you do things to me. Yeah, you put something in the air.
That's my song.
Your body's so amazing. Hey, that's why I got my hat on. You know what I'm saying? And old to August Alsina. Man, that nigga, I don't give a damn if it was mentorship, relationship. I don't give a damn what ship it was.
So, you got...
If you got to do with Jada Pinkett, hey, man.
Y'all just allegedly. Now, he stated it wasn't sexual or nothing. It wasn't no intimacy. It was just straight mentorship that she helped him through.
Well, if that's the case, then, nigga, you wasted your motherfucking time. You could have went to Ayana to fix your life.
Look. Go ahead.
What this shit? Look, I'm not going to be around Jada Pinkett hanging around her. Diddly daddling and shit and hanging with her granny. Smooches. Bitch, is we gonna do something? Well, then I got to go home.
Let me tell you this. Because when August Alsina came out, I'm not gonna lie, he's a handsome young man. He is. And when he came out, he had Chris Brown on it, he had Trey Songz on his, and he was popping.
But baby, you want mentorship, why not go to Will Smith?
Now this is another one.
Why not go to Will Smith?
He said that Will Smith gave his blessing. Now, Will Smith and Mercedes stating, and this is going to be allegedly, you guys, allegedly, that did not happen, that he did not give his full consent. So, who is telling the truth and who was lying? Now, look, we have all heard within the news about the Smith family, you know, them being swingers and all that. But no one can't really just put a bullseye on it. Like, yes, that is the truth. And if it is, they're not about to come out and tell y'all that. That is them people business. So whatever, it was a mentorship, a sexual ship, whatever you want to call it. Something happened there. We don't know that, but they know. But I know that ain't nobody that's finna come on out here and just lie like that and say, oh, yeah, it was some... No. Yeah, come on. We all know what it is. We already know what it is. But August, you can't be out here spilling the tea if that was it.
Yeah, I wouldn't have never said a motherfucking thing.
Come on.
Me personally. I wouldn't have brung up a damn thing.
That's a once in a lifetime.
All the niggas in the hood would have been like, damn, nigga, I be seeing y'all in these pictures, Jada Pinkett and shit. I'd be like, shit. She was there.
I ain't telling you nothing.
I ain't gonna tell you a bitch ass thing. Now my close partner, nigga, I be nigga, I been all got nigga, she
That's a once in a lifetime, and I'm gonna tell anybody that's a once in a lifetime. You
nigga, we don't even say it. I could.
Now we say no. That's not the case, but I do feel that. Come on now. Because if you watch her clip, if y'all watch the Red Talk table, she stated Will may be on one side of the other end of the house with somebody, and she may be on the other end of the house with somebody. Come on. That should tell y'all that, like, right there.
Well, it don't matter. That's not how she said it.
So then how she mean it?
She said Will may be on the other side of the house with some woman. Or whatever the case, but we gonna be together. You know what I'm saying?
Then her mama,
and then her mama was like,
"That's crazy to me."
Yeah, that's crazy to me. But she said, "Shit, that's what happened." I guess.
Let me tell you this.
All I know is if we're letting Jada walk around with August Alsina, no matter what the fuck they doing, you can guarantee that man had it's some shit behind it. Mm-hmm. For them to even open up their relationship, I feel like the nigga he probably got caught getting down or something. But because of how Jada is. She ain't no run to the news ass bitch like the rest of y'all is. You know what I'm saying? She gonna keep that shit inside her eyes. You know what I'm saying? So what she did was, she probably said, since this is what you doing, you know what I'm saying? And it's how you want to do it. I ain't gonna break up with you, but shit, I'm finna give me some. Okay. Bitch ass nigga, you ain't finna just be keep running around here. And come on, man, it's Will Smith.
Come on. You know, this man can have, in America.
This man can have any motherfucking woman he want. You know what I'm saying? So he probably got caught, and she probably ain't. She held it down like a real one, but she still got her in. And that's why they opened up their relationship. That's probably happened. That makes sense to me.
This is, what, 20-something years of marriage, or 20 years, however long, that they've been married. So, look, Whatever works for them, it works for them. Is it going to work for me in my household? No, because I ain't no help for coming in my house.
Man, but the you point is, if y'all sorry, paying no. attention, the point is just like people, relationships change.
Yeah.
You cannot be the same in another stage of your relationship. Right. If y'all relationship was here, when y'all met, y'all was in high school, mm-hmm. you're going to get older. Mm-hmm. You're going to change. Mm-hmm. You can't still be expecting this when y'all here.
Yeah.
They changed with their relationship. Yep. As hard as it probably was for her, she understood that if she go out there, what she had in store, just like everybody else, when you leave your relationship, you end up being a hoe. Because it's hard to find somebody. You know nigga ain't just going to be dating you without fucking. You know what I'm saying? And on the men's side, too. You yep. know what I'm saying? So you end up chasing this facade mm-hmm. of some person that you have in your mind will be the ideal person for you. And that motherfucker is not out there. And if he is, he's half of what you want. You know what I'm saying? Or you get pieces of him in trickles. Or if he all that you want, he might be gay. You know what I'm saying? So you might, you know what I'm saying? Motherfucker, she understood that, bro. Yeah. And what she did was, instead of like every other motherfucker, breaking the fuck up mm-hmm. and all your heart hurt, what she did was she stepped back and she took her emotions out of him and probably made a logical decision. Right. And that's probably why they still together to this motherfucking day. Right. But people so motherfucking, we so goddamn opinionated, we ain't getting the big picture. The picture is that they're learning how to tolerate each other. In order for a marriage to last, it ain't love. It's toleration. That's what it is. Being able to tolerate somebody. Being able to be around somebody when you're at your angriest yes. moment. You understand yes. what I'm saying? And that woman understood it. And yes. she made a motherfucking executive decision. Mm-hmm. And that's why they shocking and
that's
rocking.
That's what it is. And like I said before, it is their relationship. It's what they want to do. I mean, you know, they just got that. Probably just have that understanding. You know, look, he is a very handsome older man, and you know she is gorgeous too, and you know, come on,
that's what I'm saying. That's why I think they understood. I mean, these two people at the peak of their games can have any person in the world that they fucking want. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Sexually, I mean that's, they can have anybody, any man will want Jada Pinkett, shit, no, and any woman will want Will Smith. You know what I'm saying? No. So it's kind of like, you gonna leave this? Like, what the fuck you gonna go to? What you got? What you finna run to? You got one of the richest black men in the motherfucking world. Like, bitch, what you got? I mean, what he got? He got one of the best black women in the world. Woman who loyal. Woman who held you down. Who depicts exactly who she is in the motherfucking movies. Like, this woman is real. I don't give a fuck what she did to her face. And black women, stop this shit. You too pretty. Stop cutting on yourself. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, stop doing this.
Yeah. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Looking that's like a goddamn, sexy. Like, you can't move. Yo, damn, you stuck. You stuck. This is froze. You ever seen that movie Froze? It's froze. Yeah. Bitch.
I'm not cutting my face, y'all. I can't do all of that. I'm just so.
Tell her, wiggle your nose.
Okay. Now, I will enhance the makeup to make it look whatever, but I'm not cutting in my
yeah,
face.
Yeah, man. But so. Listen, point being is, them people have an understanding. Understand.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? And that's the thing about us black people. We so big on what we think something should be.
And so we've opinionated.
We've been, but the thing is though, what you if you think in your mind, the model of what you feel like a relationship is, where did you get it from? You got it from white people because you didn't get it from us, because in our family, it wasn't no black, it wasn't no man and no woman in the household. They took us out. Your depiction of what you think a family should be is from somebody else's vision of what family is. And you got to understand that in the world, it's billions of different people, but you modeling your relationship after one model type. It doesn't work like that. We all different, bruh.
So I'm going to say this. People. I'm going to say this, you guys. Could you do exactly what Will Smith and Jada Pinkett are doing? Could you guys open up Pandora's box and allow him to be able to have a relationship with other people?
It ain't no could you, because some of you finna lie. I'm going to stop you right here. You did it already. If you ever had a man and he cheated on you, you had a woman who cheated on you and you took her back, you already did it. All they did was they just kept it within their relationship.
Okay.
Your little dumb ass broke the fuck up and got back together, which you probably was going to do anyways.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But you're so emotional, you can't even make an executive decision. Y'all going to say, nah, I couldn't do it. Yeah, you could. You did it already. If you took somebody back, you did that. Mm. You did that. Mm. It's too late. Stop lying to yourself.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, it's just, I can't say, I mean, it is what it is, it's nothing bad, I mean, but do I feel that it's supposed to be between a man and a woman? Yes, but, you know, the way how the world is now, I mean, people are not just men and women, they want to bring in that outside, you know, maybe they want to keep
something. First off, that's what I'm saying, I'm gonna tell you something. I'm gonna keep it all the way 100 with you. Y'all want to talk about the motherland, Africa? We came from motherland. Well, if you want to go there and take their principles, in Africa, they had concubines. You understand what I'm saying? So it was already more than one wife. So y'all better stop hollering, motherland. You want to keep it real, you better keep it all the way funky. I'm telling you, your idea of relationship ain't what it was. Because if you want to talk about Africa and the motherland, they had concubines.
Okay.
They had a couple of wives. So if you want to say this the right way of life, how you going to say that? Because if you from Africa and you believe in that and you say your ancestry is from there, well, then shit, your ancestors had concubines.
And even going back to just even before that time frame, if you look at the Roman days, nobody was just married to just one person. They had outside discretions too. It's been going on for the test of times. Man. So they are open within their, I'm not going to say open within their marriage because I don't know what's going on, but we all know. Come on, you know, and then that's just them. Like I said before, it's
all I know is that little nigga should have kept his mouth shut. God damn, good talker. Oh, she was my mentor. She really helped me
out. We know exactly.
Man, get your mark ass off.
What can Jada tell you that your mother can't tell you or that your grandmother can't
tell you? What can Jada tell you that Will couldn't tell you a little better? This is the whole man who been through all. Man, get the fuck. Go ahead on down.
Okay.
Get off the screen. And because of the budget, we got to change the motherfucking subject.
They are very, 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 all of them is all too rich, I believe. So, you guys, we just want to say thank you. I know we are a little tired today. This has been a long week. But we just want to thank you guys for tuning on in. And please, again, please like, comment, and subscribe. And thank you guys for also tuning on in. We'll be back next week. Yes, sir. Bye.
Please like, comment, and subscribe.
Baby, your phone ain't even inside of the clip.
It's not? How did it happen?
You got up.